It's on. The greatest performing artist of our time in the greatest show of all time. Michael Jackson live on the History World Tour. Sydney Cricket Ground, November 14. Get your ticket to Ticketek now. Greatest songs of all time. Three of the biggest hits of 1995. And 12 more hits to come. 30 songs on one great double CD. Michael Jackson, History. History is 15 greatest hits. History is 15 brand new songs. History is 30 dynamite tracks on two CDs for only $39.95. Michael Jackson created history. Now.
Feel like
Brashers give you the chance to write your name in history. Buy Michael Jackson's History CD at Brashers and receive two tickets to an exclusive screening of Michael's new short film, plus a super poster. You'll also have the chance to write your name in history by presenting Michael with a very special history book celebrating his Australian tour. Be a part of history only at Brashers.
Show, and we'll also get
to
backstage to meet Michael.
Oh my God!
How's that, Melissa?
The best King of Pop sighting to be had today was in Sony Music's warehouse in Artarmon, where he was in pieces. A 30-metre statue of Jackson arrived today. It'll be put together in time for its debut on Sydney Harbour on Sunday, where it will look like Michael is walking on water.
Today, the Michael Jackson show rolled into Adelaide. He arrived by plane with his massive security personnel. Fans had a big decision to make: stake out the airport or his hotel for their best chance of seeing their idol.
1977, Michael goes off the wall. 1987, he gets bad. 1991, life gets dangerous. 1996, Michael Jackson makes history.
Michael, you are a legend and you'll make history.
This is the Michael Jackson Top 10 from 104.1 Today FM.
Last night, thousands of fans lined Sydney streets for a glimpse of Jackson as he arrived for the Australian premiere of his film, Ghosts. More than a dozen children accompanied Jackson to the half-hour special effects film. But Mrs. Jackson, who hasn't been seen since the confirmation of their secret midnight wedding, failed to appear. As Jackson left the cinema, hundreds of fans broke through the barricades and mobbed the King of Pop.
At age 9, he was churning out million-dollar records when his friends were still in primary school. What's happening out there at the moment?
Just when you think you're having a busy old year, Michael Jackson comes to town and the whole world goes crazy. Please. It's been incredible. All I wanna say is that they don't really care about us. All I wanna say is that
they don't really care about us. Tell me what has become of my life. I have a wife and children who love me. I'm the victim of police brutality.
Who's bad?
How do you cope with the hysteria?
I know it's all love, so it makes my heart very happy. And I like to give it back, you know, through however I can give.
Please welcome to the stage the Mr. Michael Jackson.
It was a scene echoing the Jackson hysteria Australia has been caught in all week. In the biggest gathering away from the superstars' concert venues, Jackson appeared at Melbourne's Maya Music Bowl to thank thousands of fans. Signalling throat trouble, Jackson's brief address was barely audible above his screaming fans.
Jackson. He's made history in Australia. Be a part of it with History, the number one album. Featuring 15 brand new songs, 5 smash hit singles, 15 greatest hits, 2 dynamite CDs at only $39.95.
Australia, you're the best.
Michael Jackson, History, remember the time.
Fans in Australia, you're the best. I love you. Thank you.
So what an exciting week. Are you a bit frazzled?
I wouldn't say it was exciting. I would say it was more frightening week.
A frightening week?
Well, after Hey Hey last Saturday, it all sort of started. And Hey Hey had to extend for that 10 minutes while we're trying to get the link in Sydney. And then, of course, it didn't happen, and we all looked pretty stupid because a lot of people thought maybe we were hoaxing it, but we weren't.
No, it was a genuine power failure.
It was a power failure. And I was hoping at 9:30 it would all go away and we'd be able to relax, and it became the nightmare of trying to get it again. Anyhow.
Well, it's all right. Nobody can notice those saddlebags under your eyes, Mr. Meldrum.
You went on, it was Tuesday, didn't you?
Tuesday we went to Brisbane and we went to the concert, but before the concert, Michael did this interview. I must explain, with this interview, there are major restrictions. It's not the way I normally do an interview because you have to submit the questions and they have to vet them.
Yeah.
And if you basically ask another question, they'll stop the interview and literally take the tape. That's happened before, wow. And I'll explain later how it happened to Prince with us in Japan.
Should I leave the booth?
Sorry?
Should I leave the booth then?
No.
The interview has been recorded.
No. I mean, it's pretty frightening. Right. The only other time I've ever had to do that with submitting questions was way, way back when I interviewed Prince Charles.
Yes, that's right.
And I made a disaster of that interview because I called...
Was that on the countdown?
Yeah, on the countdown days.
I didn't understand a word the silly man was saying, that's why.
Oh, he's on the phone.
No.
I didn't understand a word you were saying, Robbie.
No, I called... Yeah, I did call him, Robbie. That's right. I called Prince Charles, Robbie, as well. And I called his mum a queen. No, it's queen of mum. Yeah. I called the...
It doesn't really matter, but I know that... You're telling me that you had... this didn't happen to you last time around, but when you interviewed Prince recently...
Prince, as in Prince, yes.
As in Prince, the artist formerly known as Thing.
Prince.
And all that. You were possibly not be weren't going to be able to look at him. That was something that he's had in his interview things
when
before.
When he was here? Yeah. Way back, the artist formerly known as Prince, when he was known as Prince then...
Yes.
He wouldn't let people look at him.
Oh, God, if only we could get that in your contract.
He wouldn't let. See,
you
he wouldn't let
me alone this morning, John.
He wouldn't let this morning.
Hang on. Just now.
Carol. Just stand back here one second.
Carol.
Molly Meldrum is coming on.
Yeah.
It's almost 7:30 in the evening. We are live, and he has flown back from overseas somewhere and thinks it's morning. No. Here's Molly.
Oh, yeah. Daryl, I can explain that Molly and I were having our photographs taken while we were dressing up in ladies' clothes this morning.
You were doing a photo shoot for Cinderella.
Oh, that's right, Chris.
Right, Cinderella, the pantomime, right.
And what a tragic-looking cast that is, I tell you right now.
We'll find out on the 20th of December at the Palais.
Fantastic.
Molly Meldrum continues.
So anyhow, there were restrictions, and you'll see in the interview, we're showing part of this interview, about six minutes of it, but at the end, I tried to do a tagline for you, Daryl, and I sort of said, we'd finish the question, so I said, oh, incidentally, there's one more question I'd like to ask, and I heard everyone go, like that, and I said, it's a very personal question, but you'll see that later in the interview. So shall we have a look at Michael Jackson in interview?
Well, Michael, finally, I can say welcome to Australia, and whether you like it or not, being the king of pop and the biggest recording star in the world, what is your philosophy of staying at the top?
Well, I think being humble and believing in yourself and having true love in your heart for the world and really trying to help people through lyrics and the love of music and dance, because I truly do love people very much.
Realizing that, but does it not put pressure on you? I mean, that you have to be...
Well, it always...
holds you in such esteem, right?
It always does. The next album has to be better than the other.
Well, how do you cope with all the hysteria? I mean, wherever you go, whether it's London, whether it's Munich, whether it's New York, whether it's Bangkok, whether it's Japan, and even here in Australia, how do you cope with the hysteria?
I know it's all love, so it makes my heart very happy. And I like to give it back, you know, through however I can give. And it puts a smile on my face to see all the children and all the teenagers and the adults, the demographics. It makes my heart very, very happy. I love them. I love all the fans very much.
Well, coping with the hysteria, I mean, I can't cope with it. I mean, watching all of this going on around, I mean, the press have been absolutely manic. It's been manic mania. Can I ask you, do you ever relax? Does Michael Jackson ever relax? Because I know you're a workaholic.
Yes, I am a workaholic. I don't relax, really. I don't sleep a lot. I like to continually... my mind never stops. I'm always creating. I never stop. But I love a good water balloon fight or, you know, playing around, goofing off, Nintendo games, arcades.
Mm-hmm. Now, Michael, I have to ask you this question. Being possibly the biggest profile in the world, I guess Princess Diana matches you, you read all these amazing stories about Michael Jackson. I mean, I don't know whether they're true or not. You read that Michael Jackson's a weirdo. You read that Michael Jackson's bizarre. You read that he's done this, he's done that. Now, I know some of those stories are not true because, I mean, even I was accused of being at your wedding and I knew that wasn't true. But how do you cope? How do you feel about all the stories that are written about you?
It's very sad. I just want the fans to know and to understand that it's not the truth. 99.9% of it is not the truth. And don't read it, don't believe it, it's garbage, it's tabloid junk. I mean, they just simply make it up for greed and money. So please don't listen to it. Right. It's trash.
All right, now, there's one more question I've got to ask you. This is about a personal friend of yours, but I have got to ask you this question. I am a Stephen King fanatic. I have every book that possibly Stephen King has written.
Yeah.
You can say, mind your own business. No. And I know you've done Ghost with him, and I think that's a sensational piece of work.
Thank you.
I mean, did you enjoy doing that?
Very much, yes, yeah? Yes.
I mean, that skeleton, I mean, that blew me right out.
Were you there at the premiere?
No, but I've seen it at home, you know?
Oh.
It's just amazing. Can I ask you, what is Stephen King like?
Stephen King is a very gentle, sweet, kind man. I mean, the profile that we see in the books and in his works, and he's nothing like that. He's very humble. A lot of people try to judge me the same way, but I'm pretty simple. I love to create. I love to make magic. I love to create the unexpected, you know? And Stephen, he's just wonderful. He's not bizarre or strange or weird. He's a loving person.
And great to work with.
Great to work with. We together, he and I wrote Ghosts, and we had fun doing it.
All right, now listen, I never normally ask for autographs, but this is a Stephen King book, and it's called Insomnia, and I'm sure that over the last week I've had no sleep thinking about the Michael Jackson thing. Can you please sign this book?
Sure.
Of Stephen King's for me?
Sure.
Thanks,
thank you.
Thanks very much.
Thank you,
enjoy
Molly.
Australia.
Thank you.
And we look forward to more work from Michael Jackson, more records.
Thank you.
And being, you know, the biggest star, if they're not the biggest star in the world, and entertaining everyone.
All my love to everyone.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Make yourself
happy. Yeah. I must say, I mean, like, he really, when you talk to him like that, he really is a very, very nice guy. And a lot of our crew went to his concert in Melbourne last night, Pam and David, Georgina, and I'll let them tell you because, I mean, it's no sense me saying it. What did you think of the show?
It was fabulous, absolutely fabulous.
Yeah.
Joe, Beth and I are going tomorrow night. We're looking forward to that. Yes,
It truly is a master, and it's a fantastic show.
It's at the MCG tomorrow night.
MCG terrific. Tomorrow night, yeah.
I'm taking the footy.
All right.
Kick at half time, yeah.
Just before we go, I'm really, as I said, without Prince before. Prince, a couple of, about 3 weeks ago, all the media flew to Japan.
Yeah.
And he was going to do what we call electronic media, in other words, talk to radio and to television. And a guy from Channel V, from Asia, was the first one up and asked a personal question. He stopped, and then Keith Williams from 2 Day FM came in, and he didn't like the sound of his voice, stopped everything, seized Keith Williams' tape, and since then refuses and will not do any more electronic media.
Oh, thanks, Keith Williams.
Yeah, I know. No, that was not Keith's fault. Not Keith's fault at all. Right, so anyhow, then I was called back and he said he'd do a press interview. That is actually in TV Week this coming Monday, along with the story of Hey Hey and everything that's gone on with the whole bizarre thing with Michael Jackson. Anyway, listen, it's been, as I say, a pleasure. Let's have a look now, though, a sneak preview of Prince, his new single off the Emancipation album, and it's called Betcha, by golly, now.
You're the one that I've been waiting for forever. Never will my love for you keep growing strong.
One.
Absolutely. So there it is, Prince and Michael Jackson. And as I say, if you haven't had the chance, and certainly Perth and Adelaide, because it's coming there with Michael Jackson, do yourself a favour because it truly is a fantastic show.
Well done.
I'm going to bed now, and I'm having a nervous breakout.
Okay. It's morning. You might as well go to bed.
Molly's melodrama.